الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
وعليكم السلام ورحمة
الله وبركاته We are honored and we're gathering here today in honor of our beloved Shaykh, Mawlana Shaykh Muhammad Nazim al-Haqqari and Naqshbandi, the 40th Shaykh in the Tariqat al-Naqshbandi al-Awliya, a person who has touched so many people in so many different ways, in so many different parts of the world. There is not a country that I know of that there is not even an Azawiya set up in Tariqat al-Naqshbandi. This is the impact that Mawlana Shaykh has had. And right from this part of the world, the southern tip of Southern Africa, right to the north, from the east to the west, and thousands upon thousands, Mawlana Shaykh has inspired into the fold of Islam.
Allah.
This is the signs of wilaya, signs of sainthood. Subhanallah. When we speak about wilaya or sainthood, it is a very special rank and position given by Allah Jalla Jalaluhu to His beloved ones. It is attained by some of them due to sincere devotion and piety and actions and worship. And some attain this position from birth. It ultimately depends on Allah Jalla Jalaluhu's rahmah, His generosity and His mercy. Wilaya is basically a shadow of prophethood, if we can say it, to describe it, for paucity of words. And a wali, no matter how great he is, can never reach the daraja of a prophet or a sahaba for that matter. Please, people are in some other isms have got some kind of different notions. We have to understand many great people have graced this dunya, really, that have done tremendous amount of work. But after a period of time, they are gone and they are forgotten. Isn't it so? Subhanallah. As we are sitting here in 100 years of time, we are forgotten. Right? It's going to happen. That is the reality of life. But there is a special breed of person that is never forgotten, subhanallah. And if you can mention a few, Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani, qaddasallahu sirrahu, Khwaja Mu'inuddin Chisti, qaddasallahu sirrahu al-aziz, Shah Bahauddin Naqshband, qaddasallahu sirrahu al-aziz, Imam Bukhari, Imam Tirmidhi, Imam Shafi, Imam Hanafi, Imam Maliki, Imam Hanbali, Imam Ja'fari. May Allah be pleased with all of them. There are personalities that were born hundreds and hundreds of years ago, but they are still remembered today. Come to this part of the world, when Islam was brought to this part, the oppressors thought they brought them in chains to this part of the world, but in effect they were in chains. Subhanallah. And who are we talking about? Sheikh Abdul Rahman Matibisha, Sheikh Yusuf, Tuan Guru, Sheikh Nurul Mubin, and the list goes on. May Allah bless them. They are still being spoken about up till today. And what's once such personality that we are talking about today that has put such an impact. Although he's passed away from the dunya only a short four years, but his absence is felt. And it's none other than Mawlana Shaykh Muhammad Nazim Adil Al-Haqqari Al-Naqshbandi, subhanallah. And this is reported in a hadith where Abi Huraira radiallahu anhu qala, qala Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِذَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ الْعَبْدُ نَادَى جِبْرِيلُ. When Allah loves a certain person or a slave, He calls Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam. And what did he say? Fakal inni uhibbu fulanan. And Allah says to him, I love so and so or so and so. May Allah make us of those as well. Ya Allah. فَأَحْبِبْهُ فَيُحِبُّهُ جِبْرِيلُ. So what Allah says, I love so-and-so. So, oh Jibreel, you love him. And then Jibreel loves him. And then, فَيُنَادِي فِي أَهْلِ السَّمَاءِ. Then Jibreel announces in the heavens, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ فُلَانًا فَأَحِبُّوهُ. And it says that Allah loves so-and-so. So love him. Can also be a her. Don't. It's not a sexual thing, but this is the hadith. فَيُحِبُّهُ أَهْلُ السَّمَاءِ. And the creation in the heavens love that person. And it goes to such a degree. ثُمَّ يُوضَعُ لَهُ الْقُبُولُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Then he makes the people on earth also love him, subhanAllah. Once Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was addressing his companions and he says, you are my sahaba, you are my companions to me, but I am anxious to see the end of my nation. He's talking about us, Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that came after the companions, after the tabi'in. And what does he say? I want to see them with these eyes of mine. I love them, they are beloved to me. SubhanAllah, look how our Rasul loves us. And because they believed in me, and they believe in me, and they respect me, and when my name is mentioned, they give salat and salam upon me. And they cry from the love, and yet they didn't see me. SubhanAllah, isn't that so? SubhanAllah. And Nabi alayhi salam says, if they did see me, what will happen? Allah. And because of this, they are beloved to me, says Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam. He reported in another hadith, Inna min ibadillah la unasan ma hum bi anbiya wala shuhada. Verily, there are some people among the servants of Allah who are not prophets and they are not even martyrs. يغبطهم الأنبياء والشهداء يوم القيامة بمكانهم من الله تعالى. Yet the prophets and the martyrs on the day of يوم القيامة will admire them due to their status, their daraja which Allah has given them. Oh Allah, make us of those. Ameen. قالوا يا رسول الله تخبرنا منهم. And the Sahabi says, they said, oh Ya Rasulullah, oh Messenger of Allah, inform us, tell us, who are they? قال, and the Prophet says, هُمْ قَوْمٌ تَحَابُوا بِرُوحِ اللَّهِ. They are people who love each other with the Spirit of Allah. SubhanAllah. عَلَى غَيْرِ أَرْحَامٍ بَيْنَهُمْ. And not because of family relationship between them. وَلَا أَمْوَالٍ يَتَعَاطَوْنَهَا. Or the wealth that they have accumulated? No. فَوَاللَّهِ إِنَّ وُجُوهَهُمْ لَنُورٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ عَلَى نُورٍ. SubhanAllah. SubhanAllah. But wallahi, look what Babi says. There will be light on their faces and they will be sitting upon light. Yeah. لَا يَخَافُونَ إِذَا خَافَ النَّاسِ. They will have no fear when people are going to be fearful. وَلَا يَحْزَنُونَ إِذَا حَزِنَ النَّاسِ. And they will not be sad when people will be sad. وَقَرَأَ هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ. Then the Prophet ﷺ recited this ayah. أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Verily the friends of Allah, they shall have no fear, nor shall they grieve. So from this we can see, although we have never seen many of the Anbiya Allah, or rather the Awliya Allah, because there's a hadith of Qudsi which also says that my friends are hidden under my dome. Many of them, we don't even know if they are Awliya Allah sitting amongst us. Why? Because they are hidden. SubhanAllah. And be careful. We have to love them. And be careful of hating them. There are people in this part of the world and another part of the world, they hate. When we speak about Awliya Allah, it's like they have to stand up and they have to fight. Mawlana Shaykh Nazim has told us many years ago, they know our aqidah and we know their aqidah. Don't waste your energy. You carry on with the work. Don't get distracted. Carry on with the work. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam warns us about hating these people. Man aada li waliyan faqad adantuhu bil harb. Whoever has animosity or shows enmity to a friend of mine, a wali of mine, I declare war on that person. Allah protect us. وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِفْتَرَبْتُ عَلَيْهِ. My servant has not drawn near to me with anything more beloved to me than the religious duties that I have imposed upon him. وَمَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلْ حَتَّى أُحِبُّهُ. And my servant continues to draw close to me with the nafal, or the faral salah, rather bin nawafil, with the nafal salahs, salatu tasbih, salatu duha, etc., etc., etc. Fa'idha, to such a degree that I love that person, I love him, says Allah. Fa'idha ahbabtuhu, kuntu sam'uhu alladhi yasma'u bih. And when I love him, I am the hearing with which he hears. Wa basarahu alladhi yubsiru bih. And his seeing with which he sees. Wa yadahu allati yabtushu biha. And his hand with which he strikes. وَرِجْلَهُ الَّتِي يَمْشِي بِهَا. And his leg with which he walks. وَإِنْ سَأَلَنِي لَأُعْطِيَنَّهُ. Were he to ask me of anything, I will grant that person. Look at that. وَلَإِنْ إِسْتَعَذَنِي لَأُعِيذَنَّهُ. And were he to ask me for refuge, I would surely grant him. There are two types of wilaya. Two types. The aam, which is general, where Allah says, وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. And I am closer to you than your jugular vein, says Allah. That is in the general sense. Right? And the Quran reminds us that believers are awliya of each other, protectors of each other. وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ. As for the believing men and believing women, they are guardians and protectors of each other. يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. They enjoin good and forbid evil. وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ وَيُطِيعُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولُهُ. And they keep up prayers, and they pay zakat, and they obey Allah and his prophet. أُولَٰئِكَ سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. As for these, Allah will show mercy. Ameen, Ya Rabbi, make mercy to us. And surely Allah is wise. You know how beautiful is wilaya al-khas. Now we're speaking about the next one. The wali that are specific, close. Luqman alayhi salam tells his son, oh my son, find the awliya of Allah and love them, because Allah looks in the heart of one of them and sees your name there, and he will forgive you because of them. Subhanallah. It is said elsewhere as well that Allah looks to the heart of a wali 70 times a day. So perchance, if you sit in the company, your heart, your name is written on their heart. Subhanallah. Ya Allah. When we speak about the karamat of the awliya Allah, they are not prophets, as we said before, but they are blessed with special ranks and special favors. And each of them have been blessed with that. A supernatural act or a miracle performed by wali is known as a karamat, where it is done by the anbiya, the prophets, is mu'jizah, as we know. So there are people, when they hear or read about the awliya Allah, then he or she immediately looks for a miracle. You know, they say, that's a wali of Allah. What kind of miracle is it? That is not how it works. A mu'jiza, a Nabi is obliged to show the people. But when it comes to karamat, scraps will say in Afrikaans. If it comes to the karamat, a wali must hide it and not show it to the people. This is, and I want to share a couple of it through the Quran firstly. And such lady was none other than Sayyidina Maryam. In the Quran, what a waliyah she was. A lady wali. You've heard of Rabi'at al-Basri, for example, and so many other great ladies. Sayyidina Nafisa, cousin of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, buried in Egypt. We were so fortunate to be there. And the miracles she performed, ya Allah. But let us speak to Sayyidina Maryam. As Allah says in the Quran, بَعْدَ عَوْدُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ كُلَّمَا دَخَلَ عَلَيْهَا زَكَرِيَا الْمِحْرَابِ وَجَدَ عِنْدَهَا رِزْقًا. Every time Zakaria alayhi salam goes into her place, her hujra, and finds rizq there. قَالَ يَا مَرْيَمُ. Remember, Sayyidina Maryam was Hamil was Sayyidina Isa. And she withdrew herself alone. And she says, قَالَ يَا مَرْيَمُ أَنَّا لَكِ هَذَا. He said, oh Maryam, what is this? In other words, where did this come from? This is what the question. And what does she answer? قَالَتْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. This is from Allah. This rizq came from Allah. SubhanAllah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. For Allah provides to whom He wills without limit. Sayyidina Khidr alayhi salam is also one of those walis. Remember when he engaged Musa alayhi salam, فَوَجَدَ عَبْدًا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا أَتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِنْ عِنْدِنَا وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّا عِلْمًا. And they found one of our slaves, says Allah in the Quran, unto whom we have bestowed our mercy from us, and whom we have given عِلْمُ الْلَدُنْ, direct knowledge. This is direct knowledge, subhanAllah. Another case was the Ashabul Kahf. Remember those pious youth? They ran away from the tyrant and they hid themselves in the cave. Then there was also another in Bukhari, you will find where they were hidden. They ran into the cave for refuge, but there was a rock landslide and they were trapped. And the only way that the rocks moved was if each one had to make a dua of a good deed that they did. It's a long, I'm not going to go into that today or tonight. And every time the one person and each one made that action that he did, it was good, the rock moved by itself. By Allah's permission, of course. Even two companions, says Sayyidina Anas, they were walking on a dark night and two lights was in front of them, guiding them. When the one went left and right, the light split. This is mentioned in Bukhari, you'll find it even there. Even Sayyidina Khubayb al-Ansari, when he was captured by the unbelievers, even he says, Wallahi, I never saw a better prisoner than Khubayb. Wallahi, I found him eating from a bunch of grapes. He had this in his hand while he was shackled. In other words, he was handcuffed. And he goes further to say that there was no such kind of fruit in Makkah at the time. Subhanallah. There was also the case of Sayyidina Umar, where his son, Abdullah bin Umar, narrates that while his father was standing on the mihrab, and he says, on the mimbar rather, and he says, Ya Sariya al-Jabal! He could see, remember I gave the hadith earlier, that when Allah loves you, He becomes your eyes that you can see. And Sayyidina Umar could see his army in a far distant country is under threat of being captured or overthrown. And they saw that, subhanAllah. We had the case of Sayyidina Safina, a servant of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was left behind by the Muslim army in the land of the Romans. And it so happened he was trying to catch up and then a lion came across. A lion. Subhanallah. And he says, O Abu al-Harith, O lion, I am a servant of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he speaks to the lion and tells him his situation, and the lion shows him the way up. Subhanallah. This is the karamat of wali. I think I need to digress here. Imagine you are making salah and a lion comes passes you or coming like that towards you. What would you do? The answer is very simple, really. If your wudu isn't broken, carry on making salah. The importance, there is even Asim bin Barqiyah. Remember when Nabi Sulaiman alayhi salam wanted the throne, the arsh to come? And the jinnat said, no, I can do it, and this one can do it. And then one sahabi said, Ana atika bihi qabla an yartadda ilayka tarfuk. The sahabi said, I will bring it to you from that far place. When you put your eyes down and before you lift your eyes up, it will be there. Look at that. Do you think in Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam we haven't got such kind of people? Wallahi, I want to mention you some of the karamat of Mawlana Shaykh Nazim al-Haqqari and Naqshbandi, as reported by his son-in-law, Shaykh Hisham Kabbani. There are many, I'll just mention a few. He speaks about the chickens. There was a murid. The one brother, his name is Naqib al-Ashraf from Lebanon, and his brother was a communist, complete atheist. And his brother said, come, let us visit Sheikh Nazim. And the brother said, look, I'm a communist, I don't believe in sheikhs, you know. But it so happened that day, this communist bought some chickens, small chicks, baby chicks for his children to play with, but they all died, there were 13 of them. But then they go to Sheikh Nazim, of course, and then Sheikh Nazim said, oh, how are you? How come you come in here and you are still a communist? Sheikh Nazim tells him. And he said, yes, I'm still a communist, but I have a question for you, Sheikh Nazim. But he doesn't say Sheikh Nazim. He said, I have a question for you. And Sheikh Nazim tells him before he could even ask. He says, don't ask me that ridiculous question because all your chickens are alive. Go and see. Allah. Just like that. So they go and see. And it was alive. Subhanallah. This is the karamat of Mawlana Shaykh. As reported by many people, even was Sheikh Hisham's father. Mawlana Shaykh doesn't move from Cyprus. It so happened he moved and he came to Tripoli or to Lebanon. And he said, look, come, you must come to your father's home. Your father is going to die at such and such a time. Right? And I remember reading it in the Reader's Digest many years ago. And this was reported by Sheikh Hisham Kabbani and by other of his family members and friends that were there. And they went and they sat. To cut the long story short, they were sitting. Mawlana Sheikh was reciting Surah Yasin. When he finished reciting Surah Yasin, he passed away. And he was healthy. He was completely healthy. Look, these are all the karamats. Subhanallah. And there are so many. I will just relate two of my personal karamas which I experienced from Mawlana Sheikh Malik. The first time I went with him or to Cyprus, I said, what do I take a person like that now? So I went to the CNA and I bought him a book of the National Geographic from the Kruger National Park, a book of animals. Brother Anwar was still remembers. We were together. And so I wrapped it nicely. But when I came to Sheikh Nazim, I kissed his hand. The first thing he tells me is, what book full of animals have you got under your arm? Ittaqu firasat al-mu'min fa'innahu yanduru bi nurillah. Beware the sense of perception of that wali, that believer who's able to read you with the nur of Allah. One experience. Another experience was we went to Table Mountain when Sheikh Nazim came here. And it struck me afterwards, it was crazy. We had a small box, lunch box, you know, like they take to office, maybe 10 slices of bread in it or so. And we were probably about 30 or 40 people up there, and visitors were also coming. And Mawlana Sheikh says, give him a slice, give this one a slice. Other people from non-Muslims come and they were so interested. also giving a slice. If you have a vacuum, he slice from there. Subhanallah. This is the other thing. This is a barakah that we tend to find. We always hear the barakah that is in the food will go a long way. This is just to give you the aspect of what karamat is. Not that they wanted to show, not that Mawlana Shaykh had highlighted it, but subhanallah. It sometimes it stares us in the face and we don't even see it. Sometimes we don't even realize what we have in our community. May Allah in His infinite mercy make Mawlana Shaykh, I'm sure he's in the company of his grandfather, enjoying ma'an nabiyyin wa siddiqin wa shuhada'i wa salihin, as Allah promises that in the Quran, subhanallah. And maybe on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, drink from the hand of the hold of his grandfather Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he also stands for us at the same time, because at that time Allah will also ask and pick those whom He wants. Unasin bi imamihim, says Allah in the Quran, that He will choose whom He wants to represent you as well. So may Allah in His infinite mercy, firstly we thank Him that we were so fortunate and enough that we could be murid of Mawlana Shaykh. And I say to many of you sitting here, you might not be murid, but you're muhibbin of Mawlana Shaykh, because your love for him has made that you come here and made that barakah. We all be dressed with it forever, daiman abada, and that we emulate the lifestyle of Mawlana Shaykh, because it was nothing else but the lifestyle of his grandfather, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thank you each and every one of you for coming here and for contributing in whatever form. Allah bless each and every one of you. Subhanim Allah,
Sultanim Allah, Nabi Muhammad alayhi salam, Subhanim Allah, Sultanim Allah, Nabi